Hey everyone, this is Richard.
And this is Linda.
Welcome to the Day Zero Gamer Infinite Live Show, the show number 165 for January 11th, 2015. So, we unboxed the Edge of Tomorrow steelbook from Target, which is a pretty slick steelbook for a pretty slick movie. And speaking of which, totally watched Edge of Tomorrow. Again, it's like I had to relive the day.
Yeah, it was kind of funny that we didn't talk about it when we first watched it a while back.
I know. I started thinking about it. I was like, you know what? We never really talked about this.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we haven't loved the movie.
Absolutely. I thought it was cool. Absolutely loved it. Mm-hmm.
Totally made me think about every time we respawn in a multiplayer game. Respawning again.
Or for like a single player game where it's like, okay, checkpoint. Now I know. I know exactly what I'm supposed to do. Yeah, yep. Awesome movie. Very awesome movie. It actually reminded me a lot of Steins Gate, sort of. In the sense where the reading Steiner.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought that was awesome for somebody who, like me, is a big fan of Steins Gate. Watching this movie is just, it's great. I love the effects, the aliens.
Yeah, I love that they came up with something new and different.
Wonderful. I really, really, really wish they'd make a video game based on Edge of Tomorrow, because that would
How
be...
How cool would that be?
That would be fantastic, yeah. Outstanding. So, yes, for those who have not seen it, if you're listening to this, you seriously need to. It's an excellent movie. Really fun.
Mm-hmm. It really makes me want to go play a video game.
Yes. Speaking of video games, what is on the release agenda for this week?
Tuesday, January 13th, I got a whole lot of nothing. I don't really have anything to report for this week.
Alrighty. So what you been up to?
I've been playing a lot of Halo 5 beta.
Mm-hmm.
So much fun. I am absolutely, positively in love with the breakout mode.
Breakout.
I do way better in that mode than regular Slayer. I never would have thought that because it's just there's so much pressure and I just, I die so often.
Mm-hmm.
But I actually can hang pretty decently in there.
Yeah, you can.
And
better than I can, actually.
I love that mode. That is so fun. And I love the way it starts off.
Mm-hmm.
It's so cool. I absolutely am having so much fun with Halo 5 beta. Mm-hmm. Keep talking about it like it's the actual game.
I know.
Along with that, I've been playing a lot of Destiny. Finally got my reputation with Aeris up to a decent amount where I can purchase things that I need.
Mm-hmm.
And if you've been checking my Twitter feed, 5 Husk of the Pits
insane.
As of today.
Absolutely insane.
Yeah, and what's really insane is I got 3 of them within an hour.
Yeah, see, that is crazy.
Yeah, I had 2. I leveled up 1 to legendary, put it in my vault, leveled up the next one to legendary, and so I was just doing a, actually like 3 bounties that I could do with this one mission. So just playing the mission, and I picked up the Husk of the Pit, and I'm like, what? No way. So I went back to the tower, double-checked all my stuff, and I'm like, this is a new one, and okay. I guess it's not as rare as I thought it was going to be. So I went back, continued with the mission, got another one. And I was like, no way, I'm going to take a picture. I have 4 Husk of the Pits right now.
That's crazy.
And then I go back to the tower because I store everything in the vault. I don't like carrying a bunch of stuff with me. Only the different kinds of weapons I could use for different scenarios. Mm-hmm. But repeat weapons, like I have 2 Thorns. I keep 1 in the vault. So I go back, take a picture, and then go back, and I get another one. I'm like, what? And so I go back and I take another picture and I tweeted that and it's like, what the heck is going on? There must be a glitch. But I didn't get any more after that. So I just got lucky 3 times in a row.
Super lucky.
Yeah, it was insane.
Yeah. And for those listening, if you are playing Destiny and you happen to pick up or I guess receive an item from killing somebody that's called Husk of the Pit, make sure you don't delete it. It's a white item.
It's a white item that looks sucky.
Yeah, it does. It's an assault rifle. We have to say that.
Yes,
it's a white assault rifle.
And I do not use assault rifles. But when I get something that's rare or like cool looking, I keep it and I level it up. I'm a weirdo.
I was reading that people were just discarding it because, it's just a crappy white item.
Yeah.
Nope.
You use the white item, so the Husk of the Pit, you use that to kill Hive. That's how you level it up. You don't level it up by turning in bounties and all that stuff. Once you fill it all the way, then you have to go to Aeris and buy yourself an embalming orb. And then you use that, you level it up to a legendary. Now it's a regular legendary auto rifle.
Yep.
You level that all the way up. And then all you have to do is get a Crux of Crota, which
all you
is
have to
a
do.
Yeah, simple, right?
Eh.
That's a raid item.
From the raid on hard.
Yes.
So that's important
so,
to know.
So good luck with that. I think all of mine will be at the legendary level. Mm-hmm. But when it's a legendary, it's called an Adolin Alley. It's something like that. But yeah, so right now I have two legendary, three Husk of the Pits, just regular white item. One of them's leveled up all the way, but I don't have enough materials because I keep leveling up things.
Mm-hmm.
So I can't level that up to legendary, but I'm working on it.
And we got to throw this in there too, just to add to what you were saying. When you use that raid item, it becomes an exotic. So that's the end goal.
Yes.
I mean, you go from, you know, just a common item to a legendary to an exotic. And that's pretty neat. I mean, that's an awesome journey for a gun. I mean, you pick it up and then it just goes through that progress. And you have the potential to keep it a legendary, or I should say you have the option to keep it as a legendary
mm-hmm.
if you don't want it to be an exotic. But when it's an exotic, it has some pretty cool perks.
Yes.
So
it's a really cool auto rifle.
Yeah, it
I
looks
actually
cool.
Enjoyed using it, and I don't use auto rifles. I use hand cannons.
Mm-hmm.
So it's
yeah.
neat because I have five of them. So one's one's gonna stay legendary. One, you know, oh yeah, as soon as I get around to the hard raid, you know, not
yeah.
a big deal or anything.
Why
not? hopefully someday I can get it to exotic, and then I have three extras to do what I will. Which I'll probably just keep legendary. I know some people will be like, level it up to legendary and then dismantle. Problem is, I'm a hoarder. I have a huge arsenal that I can't seem to allow myself to dismantle. And the only time I do is because I run out of room. So I have a whole bunch of legendary and rare items that...
It's like Animal Crossing.
I just like... Yeah, I just can't get rid of them.
You just need dressers and all that.
Yes, more and more dressers and buy a second home if it allows you.
If only you could send yourself mail, like World of Warcraft.
Oh, yeah. I used to do that a lot. Actually, in Animal Crossing, that's what I do. I put
yeah,
it in the mail.
True.
I attach it to the envelope. The other problem I have with dismantling it, just like with my second thorn, right? Like people say, oh, second thorn. I'm working on my third one right now. Well, I have the bounty for it. I'm not working on it yet. But it's like, you know, you get the exotic item and then you dismantle it to get the mats that you want out of it. Problem is, I kind of like to show that, hey, look, I have five of them.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Like, if I dismantle it, I mean, I know I have the pictures, but it's not the same.
It's not the same.
Yeah.
It's like when you collect something and then you sell it off, but you sell the picture. It's not
it's
the same.
It's not the same.
You know you had it. You have proof that you had it, but you don't have it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I feel you. I really do.
So I need more characters so that they can just,
yeah.
all they do is just hold my weapons for me.
Or Bungie to update the game and give us some more bank space. Some more
oh,
vault space.
That would be great. Or make them all usable for any kind of items. Then I can use up some of the ones for the other sections. Because
mm-hmm.
my weapons one's full.
Yeah.
Actually, my armor one's probably the only one that's open. The other one's full
Same
too.
Here. Same here,
I dismantled Hunter and Titan stuff. And, I mean, obviously, I don't use those mats, so I store them in the vault. It's, oh, gosh, I have issues. I really do. I don't
think you're alone, to be honest with you.
How I can't dismantle that. I mean, what if one day?
Yeah, I know.
I might just up and decide to, like, start a new character, and I might need those mats.
Yep. Well, I mean, you have, like, what, a level 10 or 11 or 14 hunter or something like that? So,
yeah.
Yeah, it's possible. Never know.
What's funny is I'm actually the type that creates one character, loves that character,
mm-hmm.
pimps that one character out and do not need anything else. And within that, like I have two, technically three sets of armor right now. And then I have a whole slew of weapons, right? But I always lean towards the same combination. So I pretty much, like, I'd say 99% of the time only use that. Yet I have a bunch of other things I level up and I can't bear to get rid of.
Mm-hmm.
It's a disease. And that's all I played, those two games this week.
Nice. Just very nice.
Totally hooked right now. What about you?
Same two games. So Halo 5 beta and, of course, Destiny. The Halo 5 beta, again, I said it last week, I am having a blast.
I'm surprised that hasn't taken over your life completely.
Well, it's, I mean, when I say Destiny, I'm talking, I popped on, did like one or two bounties just because I want to make progress.
You worked on that raid.
Yeah, and that's exactly it. And then just got on there to work on the raid. And that was it. I mean, I've been playing literally, I'd say 99% Halo 5. It has just been fantastic. And this is just the beta. I mean, I'm content with the maps that we have. I mean, yeah, don't get me wrong. I want more maps. I want everything. I want the guns and the campaign. But I am just having such a blast.
It is darn fun for a
really
beta.
Fun.
Like,
really fun.
I'm scared when it comes out what changes and stuff.
Yep, that is my fear right now.
Because it is so fun right now. Like, that could be the full game for all I know. And,
yeah, and
I'd
be happy.
Fine. I'd play that every night, too.
I'm actually freaking out because... Not to say that this is more fun than all the other Halo games, because I don't want to say that each one was a certain point in time, like it's a moment in time.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, I've been craving Halo. And I mean, I've been having a great time with Destiny and Call of Duty Ghosts, all that stuff. But this is just super freaking fun. I'm just having a great time. And now I'm worried because, oh, geez, what if they get rid of Sprint? Or what if they change Sprint? What
they tweak something and it doesn't feel the same.
It doesn't feel the same because it feels awesome. Like everything is flowing, the boosting, the sprinting, everything is just
everything
great.
Is so solid right now.
Yep. And if it was like this but polished, I'm done.
Mm-hmm.
Here's my money. I'm throwing it at you. Yep. Just please take it. It's just
And just to reemphasize how fun it is, we have friends that are trying the beta with us that don't usually play Halo games.
Yep.
They are hooked.
Yep.
It is incredible. Like, we will play 3-4 hours straight, and they don't even blink. It's like, this is so fun. Hardly even notice the time go by.
It's January, and it's not here.
Oh, it's so far away.
I mean, I'm just so glad that the beta is still here for, like, another couple days, or, well, 10 days, right? 9 days? 8 days? It's over on the 18th, right?
7 days?
It's here for a week, and then tears.
Yeah, it's a week longer than we expected.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be 2 weeks, but I'm not going to complain,
three,
so...
Yeah, heck yes. Hey,
but yeah, Breakout,
let it go on until the end of the year.
I wouldn't.
Until the game comes out.
Fight that. But yeah, Breakout was a lot of fun. You were definitely carrying the team.
I'm so upset still, though. That one game where I was kicking butt.
I know.
And they quit the last match.
Yep.
Oh, we didn't get credit for it. So now I'm like, I'm
you
just
were,
an iron.
You were
freaking MVP.
Insane. You were awesome. And the people we were playing with, we all just didn't really get any kills. You were carrying our team and we were winning. And then nope, it's all for nothing.
Yep, they quit because they were losing.
Yep, sucks.
They wanted to manipulate the rankings, I guess.
Probably, yeah.
Or they got disconnected, but...
It's a fun mode. A really fun mode. It's not SWAT, which I know both of us, we love SWAT. But it's different enough where... I can appreciate it. I mean, there's no shields. It's one life. That's it. You know, it's cool. It's very cool.
Yeah. So fun.
Having a blast. And then, of course, you know, Destiny, which we tried the raid. It is intense. The Crota raid.
That's an understatement.
It's all the sprawl and stuff. It's bananas.
Dude, that curse really changes the game. Like, when you get mobbed, it's like, I cannot jump out of this. I can't blink away. I can't glide.
And we got to that, like, the first checkpoint before it reset, and then it reset, and then we got there again. So hopefully, I guess we have tomorrow to do it.
Yeah, and I got the same gauntlets, which was a bummer.
Well, I was happy because it's the first time I got anything in the raid.
Yeah.
Even when we were doing the other one. So, but yeah, that was fun. And I got a second Husk of the Pit. Mm-hmm. Now, we went on that big discussion talking about Husk of the Pit. So it is rare. Well, maybe not. if we're going to go by you. But it's supposedly a very rare item. I was the first one to get it out of anybody that I knew.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, my friends, they were trying to get it and they just couldn't.
They were
swarming. No luck. So I got it. I was super happy. Then, I mean, you know, I turn around, then you have five. So I don't know exactly how rare it is. And I got a second one.
Maybe
so.
Once you get one, it's like
the odds
the percentage goes up, the chance of drop.
Yeah, maybe, huh?
Because it doesn't care anymore because you can't share it with other people. There's no auction house and there's no trading.
That's true. So, yeah, I got my second one. So I definitely intend on getting that to Legendary. Well, one to Legendary, one to Exotic. If we can ever beat the raid on
Crota.
Yeah.
Say that 5 times fast.
Crota. Yeah, no thanks.
That's awesome that you tried it twice first before you said no thanks.
Yeah. But anyway, those are the two games that I played, and yeah, had a really good... Most of the week playing Halo 5 is just so much fun. I'm having fun.
We know you too well. It's
understandable. 7 days.
They're like, actually, I'm playing it right now.
Like the Ring. 7 days.
Oh, you.
Or is that, was it a whisper?
Scary.
I don't know. Whatever. So, yes, there we go. That is what we've been.
Ring. Playing. I get it.
There we what?
I said Halo. Ring. I get it.
Ooh. Dang. Yeah, that was totally intentional.
Okay, anyway, I'm sure there's some news going on.
News. Yes, speaking of Halo, we completely forgot to talk about this last show. Halo 5 Guardians additional editions, they've been announced. So there are three. Well, there's two additional editions of an edition that's like the standard edition. I'm excited.
What?
All right, so... Standard edition, $59.99, includes, of course, the copy of the game in a standard case and a poster. Pretty nifty, pretty standard.
Mm-hmm.
limited edition, $99.99. And that includes a copy of the game in a steelbook, which is fantastic.
Steelbook, woo-hoo.
Exclusive items. And I'm saying items, quote unquote, because we have no idea what that is. We don't know what that means. Possibly tangible. Not exactly sure. And the reason why I say it's possibly tangible is because it also comes with exclusive digital content. So you get some exclusive items and some DLC. So the items might be patches or, I don't know, some sort of replica or document or something. So pretty sure we're going to find out what that is before it launches. And then the third one is the Limited Collector's Edition. Now this is $249.99. And it includes everything in the Limited Edition. So, of course, the steelbook, the items, the DLC, and a commemorative numbered statue. So at this point... Just like the LE, we have no idea exactly what that statue is, what it looks like, how big it
I'm
is, or anything.
I'm excited to see that.
So definitely exciting to see.
Mm-hmm.
Is it going to be a statue of Locke or Master Chief and Locke or some sort of diorama or something? I don't know. Exciting, though. So three different options for those that are picking up Halo 5 Guardians.
Yes.
Speaking of additional editions. So the limited edition of The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask 3D has been announced. This is running $49.99, which is 10 bucks more than the standard version. And it's going to include a copy of the game as well as a mini statue of Skull Kid. So not bad. 10 bucks more. Pretty slick.
Yeah.
And lastly, Sony detailed their PlayStation Now streaming game service.
I want it now.
Now.
Yeah.
Which begins on January 13th here in the U.S. And there are going to be a few options for subscriptions. So the first one is a 7-day free trial, which will give you access to all the games for 7 days, $19.99 per month, and then $44.99 for 3 months. So that comes down to about $14.99 per month. So those are your three options for subscriptions. And there's also going to be the ability to rent games directly based on time. So you could rent a game for, say, a number of hours or a number of days. It just depends on the title. And, of course, the price based on the title, too.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the news.
Sweet.
Okay. It's time to talk about our 2015 game resolution again.
Yes.
We have some stuff to go over. So last week we both said, hey, you know what? Our resolutions are to play some games from our backlog and beat them. So you get to go first. You said you had 4 games, right?
Mm-hmm.
What are your 4 games? What are you going to beat in 2015 in addition to all the new stuff you're going to play and beat?
So I want to make sure I finish Assassin's Creed Rogue.
Nice.
So that's number one, because I got part of the way through it and then got distracted and I don't remember what happened. I mean, I was like all over that game.
Mm-hmm.
And it just, next thing you know, hey, I never finished it. Where did it go? So I definitely want to finish that. I know I'm in a really tough part of the game right now where I haven't leveled up enough.
It's your ship. You talked about that.
Yeah, I tried to go back to it. And it was like, oh, gosh, so I haven't done enough side stuff to, I guess, level up my ship, so I can't beat the mission that I'm currently on. So I'm going to have to work on that, go back and focus on that. Number two would be Watch Dogs. That was something I was so excited about, and not sure what happened there either. It just completely disappeared from my radar. It just, I don't know what happened.
Mm-hmm.
I do want to go back and play Halo 2 Anniversary. So that's definitely on my list.
We need to finish that. So we're playing co-op.
And I want to play Wolfenstein, The New Order.
Yes.
I think that would be a good one for me to finish. Now, I did have one that really, really desperately needs to be on my list. But I know for years now, I've tried to go back and replay it. And I don't know what it is. I love the game. I love the story. But I cannot for the life of me finish it. Like, I don't know what's wrong with me. But I didn't want to put it on this list because I don't want to fail.
So this will be like
so your technically extra credit. It's like my fifth okay. one. If I get through all this, this is on the list, is the two Riddick games.
Wow.
I love Riddick. I love Vin Diesel. I love Riddick. I love Riddick. And I love the game. The game was so awesome. But every time I go back to play it, I get stuck somewhere or I get distracted and it just like completely vanishes from my radar.
Yeah.
I don't know how this keeps happening. It's such an awesome game.
Yeah, it is.
I don't know what's wrong with me at all. It's just unbelievable. It's like not meant to be, not prepared for it or whatever. But that is on my radar. Just not a part of my resolution so that I don't fail.
And technically, if you were to do the Riddick game, because there's two games in there.
Yep.
And we're talking the one on the 360, right? So
yes,
it's the remastered one. And yeah, so that would technically be six games if you do both. It'd be your fifth game if you did Butcher Bay and then Assault Athena. On Dark Athena. Yeah, would be your sixth. So that would be pretty cool.
Yep.
Good list.
That's
good list.
My list. What about you?
Okay, so first one. Well, so these first two are from my original list that I failed. So I decided that, you know what, I do need to pick some games from there, and they are definitely games that I can beat. So the first one is Super Paper Mario, and this is a game that I played a long time when it first came out, and I had such an awesome time with it. I know you beat it, you played it,
it's so fun.
Enjoyed the heck out of it, yeah. So
it's a game, I gotta do it,
because it's super fun, and I know it's some of that awesome humor, you know, the dialogue and stuff, so I really want to enjoy that. The second one is Grand Theft Auto V.
Because You're so close.
I made substantial progress. I am right now, and I still have pretty much a full year to figure this part out. Part of me wants to start over. I know that'd be crazy at this point. But the first person mode. Like I'm kind of torn because
Don't start over.
I know.
Maybe I won't beat it.
But if I do, and if I don't, because you know what? It took me so long to get where I was at because I kept getting distracted. It's Grand Theft Auto. It happens. You know, I want to explore this or explore that. And so I'm thinking, you know what? If I were to focus and just get straight back to where I was at, but enjoy the first person or enjoy the option to do that or the new graphics or draw distance.
Year.
I know. Well, I'm still going to
think about it. I'm sorry. I don't have faith in that.
Well, that's true.
You get distracted so easily. You cannot tell me that you will focus and only do the main mission. I don't see that happening.
Yeah, that's... Well, yeah.
Finish it first and then go back. You're so close to the end.
That's true.
Just finish it and then go back and then redo.
All right. Yeah, I think I need to do that. But yeah, so those are the two that are from my old list. So Paper Mario, Super Paper Mario, and Grand Theft Auto V. So those two. The third one the third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. So these four games are games that are recent. And I'm saying that because, unfortunately, they went into the backlog very quickly. And I've enjoyed them. Or at least enjoyed what I've played. So, Assassin's Creed Rogue, I had a really good time with that game. I really, really, really want to beat that game. I need to. So, that's on the list. Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. I played the first, I think, two missions of campaign, and I'm talking campaign. We've played multiplayer, but I got to beat this game because I've already put time into it. I enjoy it. It's actually very interesting, and I love the gameplay. It's pretty awesome. So, I got to beat this game. Wolfenstein. You have this on your list too, so it's pretty awesome. Wolfenstein The New Order. I think I played the first mission. I need to beat this. This was awesome. I had a really good time with this game. And the last game is a game that I purchased. I've never said I played it because I haven't. I just bought it, opened it up, smelled it, and there it went in the backlog, and it's Sunset Overdrive.
Yeah.
I got to do it. Got to do it, because this game looks super fun. It's like Jet Set Radio meets...
Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Jet Set Radio was awesome.
Yeah. So I got to play this. Got to beat it. I mean, I need to seriously play it first. And hopefully I love it because then, you know, it's on my list. So maybe I'm pretty sure I'll like it. Pretty sure I'll like it. It looks fun.
Well, too bad. Yeah, you're going to have to beat
it. It's on there now. But if I beat these six, then my seventh would be Riddick. Or it's going to be Riddick. So that's funny that you mentioned it, and that's going to go full circle. That's my seventh. So if I can beat these six, it's not going to redeem last year from, you know, failing the list that I had. But I think that if I can do these six and maybe do one more, then yeah, I would pick Riddick, because that's a game that I also really, really wanted to go through.
Awesome.
We'll see. We will see. The Grand Theft Auto 5 one is it's the questionable. I'm so close, but I might get distracted. I don't know. I'm losing faith in myself.
Knowing your history, are you sure Grand Theft Auto 5 is the only questionable item?
Assassin's Creed 2, yeah, I might get distracted.
That one is, yes.
Yeah, Paper Mario.
With all the sailing,
And you know what? Sunset Overdrive 2, I'm a little concerned about that, because it is open world, and if I'm having a blast just like grinding and blowing stuff up and...
Okay, we'll see how this year goes.
And we shall see.
If it's bad, then maybe next year we will work together to pick out games that are a little more linear, a little more
that are
controlled.
Controlled, yeah. Yeah, and I mean, seriously, we've talked about our most anticipated games last week, and I mean, yeah, I need to do these games. I need to beat these games with those other games. I mean, the Tomb Raider and the next Zelda game, and of course Halo 5. This has to be done. These games have got to be done before Halo comes out, because if not, I failed again. So there we go. Our six. Well, my six, your four. Technically, your six. My eight, if we can count Riddick. Those are games.
Be optimistic, yes.
So there we go.
Sweet.
And with that, we wanted to thank everyone who took the time to listen to the show. Be on the lookout next Monday for show number 166. Special thanks to Random Jankies for providing this organized fun for the Infinite Live Show theme song.
Have a great week, guys.